1595. Her true name was Matoka, but all her tribe called her by that name. Pocahontas was one of many daughters of a powerful chief named Powhatan. Her father ruled more than 25 tribes.
English colonists settled in the area near Pocahontas in 1607. One day, when Pocahontas was 12 years old, her brother came home from the forest with a very exciting story.
What's the matter, brother?
Is there any news from the seashore?
Son, speak.
I saw three big canoes with white manes. The men in the canoes were very strange. Their skin was white.
White? Are you serious?
That's ridiculous, Pocahontas. Do you really believe him?
I swear, it's unbelievable.
I thought human beings have reddish brown skin.
They speak strange words and sounds, unlike any creature I've seen before.
That's interesting. I want to see them.
Stop it, you idiot. Don't believe him. He's just trying to draw some attention.
I know it sounds crazy, but they are people just like us, but different, so different.
Those aren't people. They must be demons.
I know many stories about these white men. They want to take our land from us. We must fight them.
The land? No way. We must kill them before they kill us.
But brother, those white men have sticks that though. Those sticks make a lot of noise, and their sound is really scary and dangerous.
Those sticks called guns, my son.
The guns are better than bows and arrows.
What? They have better weapons? What do they use them for?
They are for hunting and good for fighting. We must find a way to take it from the white men.
But they can beat us with the guns.
Listen, my son. Weapons can beat the flesh, but weapons can never beat the spirit. Our spirit is rooted in our land. They can never take our land from us as long as you have a spirit. This is our home, our land, our spirit. Just keep your faith strong.
What's the plan?
You mind if you? We'll go and watch them every day. First, we must know what they are doing.
Pocahontas sat and listened all night to what her tribe was planning to do. She thought differently. She was always being precautious. She always listened carefully, and then she makes sure her voice is heard.
But father, why to fight them? Killing is not in our faith. We live in harmony with all our surroundings, animals, seas, trees, and birds. But why not with white people? Maybe we can be friends with them. If they're different from us, we can learn new things from them. There must be a way we can live together.
Oh, big mouth, can't you save a lecture to yourself?
This matter is none of your business.
Leave her alone. She's free to think whatever she wants.
Listen to me, daughter. This issue is bigger than what you think. Will you please trust your father?
Sure, Dad.
Good job, guys. Good job. Here we go. We're almost done.
I can't hold it anymore. Son, dizzy.
Come on, Len. James said it's a stake. It's now or never.
I know. It's been hard for everyone here, but that's the way it was for us.
Joe, Mark, and Tom, you should understand that we must finish building the fort before the native come and fight us.
Yes. You are right. We came here for God, gold and glory. We mustn't give up.
God bless us.
God bless America.
So every day, Pocahontas' big brother watched the white men and came home with the news about them.
Father, listen. They are building huge wooden houses, and many of them are ill and hungry. They don't have enough food.
God, I wish all these demons die from hunger.
Oh, have pity these white men. Father, we can help these men.
Pocahontas listened very carefully to her brother's story. She felt sorry for the white man.
What did you say, daughter? Help them?
Yes, father. We can send them some of our corn, and we can send them our shaman to cure them too.
Let the white men be hungry. They will go away and leave us alone on our land. We don't want them here.
One day, Pocahontas' uncle and his warriors killed many white men and took Colonel John Smith as a prisoner.
Stop shooting! Stop shooting! A man is down!
A man is down! We got him!
Come with us. Our ship fought and we'll see what we can do with you. You are a demon.
Why did you bring him here? I don't want to see any of these white men on my land.
We can use him as a hostage, chief.
This man must die. Kill him.
On your knees.
Stop. Father, please, don't let them kill him. This man is very brave.
This white man is brave. He has a pure spirit. Untie his hand.
And so, Pocahontas saved the life of Captain John Smith. Powhatan and some Indians made a peace agreement with Captain John Smith.
Okay.
You're free now, Captain.
But don't forget to send the gun.
God willing. I thank you, little lady.
You are courageous, and you deserve to live.
After Smith promised to send guns, he returned to Jamestown. He did not send the guns, but sent many other presents instead.
Hello. This is for the chief.
Thank you.
Wow.
Over the next year, Pocahontas and other Indians visited the fort and brought food for the settlers.
Hi. This is for Captain John Smith.
There was peace between the Indians and the white men.
Oh God!
Shh, be quiet, she's coming.
Oh no! Help! Please help!
Don't be afraid, we are not going to hurt you.
Who are you? What do you want from me? Please let me go, please!
We need you to stay with us. Your father and his warriors won't fight us.
Oh my. You should have listened to my brother. Please let me go. Please. I promise I won't come around here again.
Don't worry. We will take you to a safe place. You will stay at the minister's home. So his wife is a righteous woman and she will take care of you until the situation gets calm.
While living in Jamestown, Pocahontas converted to Christianity and changed her name to Rebecca.
What did you say, Father? Will you accept their invitation? If I were you, I would turn this wedding into a massacre. It's up to you, Chief. I will do whatever you say.
Pocahontas is my daughter, my blood. I can't hurt her. You, my brother and son, go and celebrate with her. Take this and give it to Pocahontas. And tell her not to forget her bond with this precious land.
The marriage helped ending the war between Powhatan and the settlers. She was a symbol of peace and union between their two races. In 1615, Rolf and Pocahontas had their first and only child, Thomas. The following year,
my dear, we will travel to the old world, my homeland, England. The English people are very eager to see you. They have heard a lot of your good deeds to the settlers, and it's time to meet them.
But we're coming back to Virginia, aren't we?
Of course, this is our home.
The English people were excited to know Pocahontas. There were many parties for her. Famous artists even painted portraits for her. Pocahontas was treated royally by the king and queen.
Oh, hello, my dear Pocahontas. Long time no see.
Hello, my dear friend. Very nice place.
Believe me, there's nothing more beautiful than Jamestown. I miss my friend there.
Everyone misses you, too. We were worried about you after the gunpowder accident. Things have never been the same since you left.
Without you, there was no peace in the new world. So how do you find the old world down here? Something wrong? Something wrong?
Pocahontas became seriously ill just before she was getting ready to return to Virginia. She died in England in March 1617. At the age of 21, Pocahontas was buried in England. Her son, Thomas, grew up in England. He returned to America at the age of 20 and became an important member of the community.
People will always remember my mother Pocahontas to keep peace between the colonists and the Indians. I will make my best to follow my mother's effort to keep peace relations between my people. I say to you, my beloved people, white people and the natives, we are all Americans. God bless America.
Pocahontas remains as an important part of American history.
What did you say, daughter? Help them.
Help them. All right. تمام شوي. إيش النص اللي قبل God Bless America؟
Don't be afraid, we are not going to hurt you.
Tita. Munir. Munir مطلطل علينا.